The system's breaking down. I think there's been a glitch.
Yes, that is snow you're seeing, and you are hearing the word glitch, and it's from Taylor Swift's new album, Midnights. We're playing it to you because Ticketmaster had a glitch and failed millions of fans trying to get their concert tickets for Taylor Swift. Can you describe what happened?
So their site was down for a bit yesterday. There was double the demand for Taylor tickets, and they actually had tickets. So big problem. It all happened during the pre-sale period. This is where it gets somewhat confusing. So real fans worked hard to get this special code that put them in line online to actually buy the tickets. But they couldn't actually buy the tickets. So people are mad. And AOC, as in Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, says, well, this is a daily reminder that Ticketmaster is a monopoly. Its merger with Live Nation should never have been approved. Break them up. Well, five members of Congress wrote a letter to President Biden to investigate that merger. It was during President Obama's DOJ back in 2010. I think I agree with AOC. There's no competition here. You pay exorbitant fees. You have robots come in and try to buy all these tickets. You have websites going down. Ticketmaster was trying to prevent all of this. Couldn't. And some tickets sold for $35,000 a pop.
You sound so passionate about this, and you are pounding the table. Were you in line for these tickets?
No, but I know people who were.
So do I. So you think they should be broken up, right?
I don't know about broken up, but this does sound like a monopoly, and it seems to be a big problem
it's
for a lot of fans.
It's very bad PR, and that's
for more than just Taylor Swift. Bruce Springsteen, the list goes on.
All right, now, let's get serious.
Sure.
The FBI has been sounding the alarm on TikTok. Now, what are they worried about?
So the FBI director, Christopher Wray, says Beijing just has too much control, and he cited three specific areas. The way they collect data on users, the way they recommend algorithms that could be used for influence operations, and then they could actually get into your device. Of course, that compromises your phone and data. Obviously, TikTok has long been controversial. 60 Minutes just ran this piece. It said, if you look at TikTok in China, the way it operates, you get the spinach version, right? Young kids, time limits, they see science experiments. The TikTok version that you see outside of China, like here in the US, that's the opium version. That's the one where you don't see as many science projects. You see things that get kids addicted, right? The nonsense.
So there's a difference.
There's a difference.
Okay, shouldn't have that. Thanks so much, Lauren. Coming up,